Hi students, this is Ramya from Pharmatutes and today I'm going to discuss about the Beckman rearrangement. Rearrangement means it is a migration of group from one to another atom within a molecule. So it is a rearrangement of an oxime functional group to a substituted amide in the presence of acid. So it is a rearrangement of oxime to amide in the presence of acid. So what is oxime? Oxime which contains C double bond N OH group. So this is oxime. So how it is prepared? It is prepared from ketone. When ketone is treated with hydroxyl amine. Hydroxyl amine means having hydroxyl group attached to the amine. So when it will undergo dehydration, when ketone is treated with hydroxyl amine, it will undergo dehydration to give oxime. So this is oxime. This will undergo rearrangement in the presence of acid. It will give substituted amide. So this is oxime functional group C double bond NOH and it is converted to amide. So this is amide, substituted amide. So it is substituted with R groups or it can be aryl groups. Even it can undergo for cyclic oxymes also will undergo rearrangement. So this is Beckman rearrangement. So now we will see the mechanism involved in this reaction. What is the mechanism? The first step in this rearrangement is protonation. Protonation means proton is added. So first step is protonation. So here oxime is converting to amide. So oxime, it will accept a proton. So here we hydroxyl group is there. So this will accept a proton from the acid. Acid is what? It will donate a protons. So it will donate a proton to oxime. So H plus is added. So where it is added? To the electron rich oxygen. So here oxime accepts proton from the acid. So this is first step involved. And now so this next step is migration of alkyl group. So first, so in this step, we have two alkyl groups here. So which alkyl group will be migrated? We'll see now. See, after protonation, see OH was bad leaving group. So once it is protonated, it became good leaving group. So then this water molecule will go off as a water. So once it leaves from the nitrogen, so then this nitrogen will become highly electron deficient. So to neutralize it, this unstable nitrogen, when it water molecule goes off, this will become electron deficient and it is highly unstable. So to make it stable, the alkyl group will migrate to the electron deficient nitrogen. But here we have two alkyl groups. So which alkyl group will migrate? So here one alkyl group is in the syn position, or it is in the same position where the OH is present, and another alkyl group is in the anti position, or it is trans to the hydroxyl group. So the alkyl group which is trans to the hydroxyl group will be migrated, because if the syn group cannot migrate because of the steric hindrance, due to the steric problems, steric hindrance, so syn alkyl group cannot migrate. So anti alkyl group easily migrate to neutralize the electron deficient nitrogen. See, this R group will migrate to this nitrogen. So now since it is providing alkyl groups to the nitrogen, so this carbon becomes cation. So we got a carbocation in this step. So in the second step, that is migration of alkyl group. So where it is migrated? To electron deficient nitrogen. So migration of alkyl group to electron deficient nitrogen to form a carbocation. So this is second step. And next, what happens once the carbocation forms? So here we got a water molecule. This water molecule will attack the carbocation. So where it will attack? See, this OH from the water will attack the carbocation. So now OH will attack carbocation. So what we got here? So we got alcohol, right? So this is alcohol, and also we have alkene, that is en. So it is enol. So we got enol from the third step when water molecule attacks. So once the enol forms, it undergo tautomerism. So enol will undergo tautomerism to keto form. So it fourth step is keto enol tautomerism. So once the enol forms, it undergo tautomerism. So how the tautomerism occurs? See, we have C double bond N, and here we have hydroxyl group. So when this hydrogen will go as a proton, and here the electrons will come, and this electrons will move here, and this electrons will come here. So this nitrogen becomes negative, and the proton which has gone as H plus will attack the nitrogen. So finally we'll get see here, this bond moves here, so C double bond O, and this bond moves here, so N, and this hydrogen comes here, so we are getting amide bond from this keto enol tautomerism. So enol is converting to keto form. See here, this bond is become C double bond O, and this is single bond, and this hydrogen proton will attack the nitrogen, so we got the amide bond. So we got amide from oxime. So oxime is converted to amide from Beckmann rearrangement. So this is the mechanism involved in the Beckmann rearrangement. So now we'll see some important applications and stereochemistry of the reaction. So important application is conversion of oxime to amides. And even we can convert cyclic oxime to cyclic amides. And cyclic amides are called as lactams. So let's take an example. So it is very important in synthesis of caprolactam. So now we'll see what is caprolactam, how it is synthesized. So when we convert ketone, that is cyclic ketone, so this is cyclohexanone. So when cyclohexanone is converted to oxime, so how it is converted? So what is oxime? It is C double bond N OH. So how it is converted? In the presence of hydroxylamine, cyclic ketone is converted to cyclic oxime. So this oxime is converted to lactam or cyclic amide in the presence of acid. So in the presence of acid, as oxime is converted to amide. So here cyclic oxime, so cyclic oxime is converted to cyclic amide. So here this R group is anti to this OH, so this group will migrate and it will attack nitrogen, and this nitrogen is inserted in this ring. So now this oxime is 6-membered ring, and when undergo rearrangement or migration, it will become 7-membered ring. So nitrogen is inserted, and the group which is syn to this will get carbonyl, so C double bond O, and it will once in the mechanism we have seen, so how we got the amide bond. So this is the structure of caprolactam. So this is very important applications of Beckmann rearrangement. So stereochemistry is highly stereospecific. So Beckmann rearrangement is stereospecific reaction, and the groove which is anti-periplanar to the leaving groove will be migrated. So Beckmann reagent is highly stereospecific, and the groove which is anti-periplanar. So this is the groove which is anti to this leaving group. So OH will go as a living group. And after protonation, it will go as a water molecule. So finally, we'll get a amide bond. So it is very simple to write a Beckmann product because it is highly stereospecific reaction. So when we take this example, so how to write? So in the presence of proton, so here first we should check which is syn group and which is anti group. So here the syn group is aryl group and the anti group is R. So now we should start with the syn group, that is aryl group. Then we should write amide bond. So here the oxime is converted to amide. So next after amide we should write the anti group. So this is very simple to write the product in the Beckmann rearrangement. So it is very easy to predict the product. See in this reaction, so in this example, so when the presence of acid, so it will undergo rearrangement to amide. So now we have two groups. So here this group is syn group and this is anti group. So we'll start with syn group. So then amide bond. So then we will write anti group, that is aryl group. See, it is very easy to predict the Beckmann product. So easily the oxymes are converted to amides and it is substituted amides. So this is about Beckmann rearrangement. So if you understood, please subscribe my channel, and if you have any doubts you can leave a comment. So thank you very much for watching the video.